Let's go down south to Texas. Houston Texans, that is, with the Houston Texans. Brandin Cooks says that on Monday during a press conference that he wants out of Houston. He is tired of covering up this drama and everything else. He wants out. Right? No surprise to us, right? No surprise whatsoever. During the season, week 12, week 13, when the Houston Texans were first eliminated from the playoffs, he says, you know what? I'm not going to play anymore. He sat down for 3 or 4 games. He said, I want to be traded. He never got traded, sat out for 3 or 4 games, and then he come back and play the last couple games of the season, giving him like 706 yards to finish out the season. So when we think of Brandin Cooks, do we think of elite wide receivers? When we hear the name Brandin Cooks, do we think of top 10, top 5, hell, even top 15 receiver in the league? Absolutely not. But when we dive into the stats here, guys, he has spent 10 seasons in the NFL. 10. 10. A motherfucking 10, right? 7 of those 10 seasons, he has 1,000 yards plus receiving. With the Rams, with the Patriots, and 2 with the Houston Texans. This season with the Texans, he probably would have broke that 1,000 yards if he wouldn't have sat out for 4 or 5 games. So is it an overreaction that Brandin Cooks' value out there is going to be very, very sought after, much like Odell Beckham Jr. in this offseason? Guys, that is an overreaction. Why? Not because the stats are not there. Not because the worth isn't there. Not because the production value is not there. It is the price tag. Why did the Packers, Giants, and Cowboys all pass on him during the trade deadline? The price tag. It was the price tag at the end of the day. Let's just be flat out honest. He has another year on his contract with the Houston Texans. He's going to make $30 to $40 million. I should have looked that up. But it is a very, very steep price tag. Now, maybe the Houston Texans can cut him or do a sign and trade type of thing. I don't know. Clearly, nobody really wants to work with the Houston Texans. Why? I don't know. I don't know. But Brandin Cooks will not be sought after this offseason at a very high rate. It is going to take a team like a desperate team. Let's think of a desperate team. The New York Football Giants might be desperate. The Jets might be desperate. I don't know. Are the Packers desperate? I think they got a pretty good young receiver core. There are really no, quote, desperate teams out there that could really use the services of an 11-year veteran. Especially a very high-paid 11-year veteran. If we want to overpay for a veteran that is out there, Odell Beckham Jr., look no further than that. Granted, he has 2 ACL injuries in 3 seasons, right? But at the same time, he is not going to warrant that $40 million. Unfortunately, Brandin Cooks' stats are there. 7 seasons of 1,000-plus yards. His rookie season, 623. His last season with the Rams, 635. And the last season, 706. The stats are there. The worth ethic is there. The catch rate is there. He has over a 65% catch rate. So when a ball is thrown to him 65% of the time, he's going to catch the ball. 15th highest in the NFL the last 4 seasons. But unfortunately, it is an overreaction. There's not going to be a very big market for Brandin Cooks this season. So whether the Houston Texans eat most of that money or somehow find a desperate team out there, I don't know. I'm just
checking out that man hour.
It's not
going
to happen at the end.
If you're interested in the next video, click the link right here. Of course, subscribe right here. And always join us Monday through Friday, 8 p.m. East Coast time, right here where you're watching this clip. And as always, Man Hour Nation, rise up.